What's good, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Fun with Dumb. This is the travel edition. We're here broadcasting live from Seoul, Korea at my friend's studio, Collab Asia. So thank you, Collab Asia, for letting us use the studio. And I have a travel partner with me, Donnie Kwak, GM of Complex Media. How you doing, sir?
I'm doing great. Honored to be here.
Yeah, man. We're traveling right now. We're on vacation, but we decided to make a few stops and get some work done as well. And Korea's been great. We've been eating good food, doing cultural events,
hiking,
wearing hanboks down the street for no reason.
That's a damn lie.
Yeah. And we're interviewing some really incredible people. And this is one of my best friends probably in Korea, I would say. I can confidently say that. She's held me down here. You know, you got that one homie in every country or every city holding you down, making sure you're taken care of. She is that person. I am here with the one and only Jessi.
What an intro.
Wow. I feel so... That was so welcoming.
That was a sweet intro, actually.
That was
sweet.
Great.
I was starting to get choked up.
Hi, guys. I'm Jessi. Nice to meet you guys. Thank you. That was a really good intro.
I know you
improved.
Yeah.
You improved
we
a lot.
We actually did do a pod episode, early days of Fun with Dumb. Mm. One of the most viewed, one of the most downloaded. But at the time, it was a little awkward for some reason, even though we were friends. I think it was
weird.
I think
that was why. I think because we're really friends. And you didn't have anything scripted.
Wait, how many years ago was that?
Like five.
Five years ago.
That was like 5 years ago.
Yeah.
And that was also very like abruptly. He just like, can you come do the podcast? Same as today.
I was nervous. I'm always kind of nervous.
You're nervous right now, right?
A little bit.
Yeah, I'm a little bit.
Yeah.
I could tell.
Yeah, my butthole's a little clenched. It's a little clenched. But no, I don't know why. I think just because usually when we're together, just working maybe the studio or just hanging out, it's very natural. But like on an interview thing, I think I've seen so many interviews where you're just so overpowering personality-wise, and it's funny that I'm like, oh, damn it, I feel like it is an expectation to live up to a little bit.
No, you know what I'm saying? No, you're doing a great job. No. I'm actually very, like, low-key now. Like, can you hear my voice is very low?
I guess. I don't know. I can't.
My tension is very low these days.
Yeah. Why is your tension lower?
Why?
Yeah.
I think I'm just getting older. Mm. And like, I'm kind of burnt out, to be honest.
Yeah.
Because I've been doing a lot of shows and switching companies and having so many different decisions and stuff like that. So this is actually my first podcast or after my show to view and just like any TV shows in general.
Yeah.
So what's like a typical day for you these days?
I work and I go home and sleep. That's all I do.
What does work look like for you though? I want to know, like, just to break
right
down from beginning in the morning to the end of the day, like on a busy day where you're doing everything off the checklist of work.
When you met, so like 2 years ago when I was in my previous company, at that time I was actually super busy to the point where I wouldn't even remember anything. But now I'm more, everything's more flexible and I do work that I want to do. Mm. So I do less TV. I do less podcasts. I do less talking. I'm trying to focus on myself right now.
But there was a moment you were on TV a lot.
Yeah, that was 2 years ago for 3 years straight. Like I was on every TV show where I was so sick of myself, even like myself. I was just like, bro, I can't watch myself. Like, now I'm kind of like getting older and I'm just like kind of reflecting and just figuring myself out. And it's kind of weird because like you would think that when you get older, you have all your shit together, right? But I'm like, this is like a new chapter for me, a new beginning.
Was there ever a point in your career where you're doing so much TV and you're used to regularly being out there in the public, but did you get scared ever to like be quiet where you feel like you'll lose relevancy because you're not visible anymore?
Of course. I think we all have that.
Yeah.
There was a point in time I was always like, I got to work because I was scared that people would forget me. But now I'm just like, I don't give a fuck. Like, I think my happiness is more important.
Right.
And there was a point in time, I think it was last year around the time I was doing the Europe tour. That's when I completely lost myself and I lost all my people. Everyone fucked me over and like, that's when I realized, wow, this is the time where I need to really get back into my sense and like figure out my life and who my people are and my surroundings. And I was in a really bad place for 2 years, but I'm just still trying to figure it out right now, and I think that's a part of life. So,
but you feel like you're in a better place?
No, not really. But I pretend. I pretend because I think. So I'll give you like an example. Like, I was there was a part of time like last year I was really tan from the sun. Yeah. I was in the sun a lot, and everybody was saying you were trying to be like you were
dark skinned.
You're dark. You're trying to be dark skinned. And then now I don't tan, so they're like, now you want to be white. So I'm like, what the hell do you want?
When it's literally just the sun.
It's the sun. And like, and I realize like the internet always wins. So it's like, I can't win. So it's Wait, whatever I do.
Are these global fans or?
I think, no, they're just bots. They're little kids. Because I would reply back and then I see their answer and then they remove their Instagram. Mm.
Yeah.
Like I love on them. It's like my hobby. But now it's just like, I look at their Instagram, they're like 13 years old.
But it's also hard to go against the internet. You know, so I used to be like fighting one-offs and then it was like zombies, like a thousand.
It depends on how you fight. You can't attack them. You got to say something where they can't say anything back, you know? But for me, even that now, it's like such a waste of time. And I'm just like not really into all that. I'm just trying to figure myself out, to be honest. And
what have you figured out?
Yeah, where are you in the journey? Because it sounds
I'm not going to lie, nothing. I'm fucking fried right now. Like, I don't, like, for example, like, I'm trying to work on my album. I'm in a new company, starting a new journey again, which is not bad, you know? I'm working on my album, but I'm just so, I know my fans are so eager for my album because I haven't dropped an album in, like, decades. Yeah. So, I know I could make an album, but I'm so, I think because of like the whole 2 years of just so much work and like all of that, it just really messed me up. And now I don't, my vision's all gone.
Mm. Do you feel inspired to create?
No, I don't. But I'm trying because I know that at the end of the day, I'll get back into the loop, you know, like I'll figure it out. I always do. But I think now that I'm older and more woke and just wiser, I just like, I'm like, okay, let me stop going to war with people. Let me just figure my shit out.
Is there anything that you do? Do you actually, do you like meditate or go to Pilates or yoga? Is there, do you have anything like that in your life if it's not that?
So a lot of people have been recommending me that, but knowing my personality, like somebody was like, okay, Jess, I think you need therapy.
For example, nothing's wrong with therapy.
Like, I think mental illness is something very important to
talk about. Have you ever had a session? Like a therapy session?
So knowing me, I'm like, okay, let me take a day off and let me fucking go to a fucking therapist.
Yeah.
And I realized I'm probably going to change my therapist again. So knowing myself, like I'm never like, I have trust issues, which you shouldn't have trust issues with your therapist, but you also need to be connected with the therapist. But knowing me in Korea, I can't speak Korean. I'm in Korean. Am I going to like tell them my whole story in Korean?
Yeah.
It's hard. So I think I wasn't able to really, I have like a fear of going to therapy, which I should.
She'll switch therapists like her labels.
Yeah, just, like just.
But you can definitely do therapy over Zoom now, you know? So you can get an English speaking, like someone in
now,
the States.
So like with Zoom too, I'm very awkward with Zoom. Like I don't like Zoom. I don't like FaceTime. It's so awkward.
So you'd rather do it in person?
Yeah, because I think it's more intimate and there's more like feelings there, you know, like rather than I like meeting people face to face rather than a Zoom call or like something like that. You know, it's just, I don't know. It's like weird these days. Everything is all technology. It's just like,
yeah. And you're really not tech savvy.
No, you've seen me text.
Oh, yeah. It's been
like,
bad.
It's surprising. Like, you know, my new label, the managers have no idea what I'm saying because it's because of my nails and I'm not really a texter. I like talking, but,
do you do voice memos?
No, I don't even know how to do that.
What's up, y'all? This episode is sponsored by the Asian Canadian food distributor, Ran Foods. They're giving away a 1-year supply of free ramen. Who does not like that? Come on, man. If you want to enter, head over to their Instagram at Ran Foods Inc. That's RanFoodsInc. And check out their pinned post for more info. Shout out to Ran Foods and make sure you tell them Fun with Dumb sent you. Now enjoy this clip of Rick eating some ramen.
Thanks, Dumb. What's up, Fun with Dumb crew? Today we were supposed to have ramen, but the noodles were so fire that customs confiscated it. So instead, I'm gonna have pad thai. As you can tell, this company has all different types of noodles. Pad Thais, pho's, they have sriracha sauces, soy sauces. But today we're focusing on this. I'm so excited. I love it when they get fried garlic pieces. Let's taste it. Just a little bit. I ran through that. And now back to the pod.
The one thing I'll say about you, though, you're very good with communicating with your friends, I mean, or your fans on tech, yeah. Right? Like, you comment a lot, reply to people.
Yeah.
Do you also see certain DMs from people as well?
No, I don't.
You don't?
To be honest, like, my DMs are flooded. So, yeah. You know, I don't click on it. And I feel like if I want to, I wish I could, but like, if I look at everyone's DM, obviously I have to DM everyone.
Well, is it like a graveyard of like celebrity DMs in there? Like,
I mean,
or have you seen certain, or you responded to somebody that you might recognize?
Yeah, many, many. But I'm very good at like keeping it very business, and like I'm not the type of person to.
DM sliding in there?
Of course.
Yeah.
Listen, I'm 34 now.
Yeah.
Like, I can do whatever the fuck I want.
Right, right.
And I'm trying to find love right now. Mm. So.
How's that going?
Not good. Nothing is going good. Like I said, I'm like a mom without a child right now. Like, I want a child, but how can I have a child if I don't have a man, right? But then I'm like, I can. Right?
You could.
What are the options?
Like, I gotta freeze my eggs.
Right.
That's first thing first because I'm getting older now, so
yeah.
I don't want to have a child. I might not be able to have a child when I'm like 40, right? So I mean, there's a lot of balance right now. Like, am I going to give up like the whole love, family, like kids, having a family, or am I going to continue pursuing this career right now? So there's balance.
How would the process of dating Jessi look like?
I mean, how would you even find someone to date?
No, I'm like saying
on the app.
Well, that's what I mean.
Mean?
Is it, would it be? I'm saying, would it be like an app, or would like somebody,
an app?
Or would somebody slide into your DM? And would it be easier if it's somebody in your industry? Like,
what would the process look like? No, absolutely not. I wouldn't date anyone in this industry.
You need to vibe in the first 5 minutes,
yeah.
Or it's not going to work.
Yeah, like I can't say that that's right.
Yeah.
But just. I go off of my feeling of when I meet them.
No, I think that's right, though. Your first
instinct. And like, it's just like you talk about what they want, what they're driven. Like, what do you do? What do you do? And like, what do you like? And those are the things that you, it's just like the energy, you know? And like, I feel like, I don't want to say this, like, but I am. There's not really any like men these days. Like, you know what, like masculine men. When I'm talking about masculine, I don't mean like bulk. Dudes like like dumb right now. I'm talking about like masculine men. Like, where are those guys? You know, like someone like my brother and my dad. They're
what makes a masculine?
Yeah, what do you want in a masculine man?
Like change of tire type.
It has nothing to do with looks. It's just a guy who can just like support you and like no jealousy. Just like, you know, it's not easy dating me. You know, because, you know, like I said, I'm kind of like an alpha. You
right,
know,
right.
So. I got to meet someone who's more alpha than me.
So you want more alpha, you don't want a beta.
No,
because a lot of alpha homegirls that I have a little bit more of a beta boyfriend situation.
Because I have dated someone that was very, very a yes man, and it was very sweet, but then it gets boring because they're just a yes man. I want a guy that would be like, Jess, get your shit together. Like, do this, do that. Like, I like that, you know?
So they don't have to hold your shopping bags down Apgujeong.
Like. Ew, no. And I don't like that shit. I don't like that. I don't like it. If a woman is carrying a bag, why are you making your man carry it? I don't like that shit. Mm. It's weird. So I don't know. I feel like with men, like I realize at the end of the day, you can't try to find love. It's going to come to you. And I think that you know, that's something that I just have to wait for.
Well, with someone like your schedule, would it have to be somebody coming at you very straightforward, not wasting time, like a DM, like, hey, we should go grab dinner? Like, would that be a first message that possibly could lead to a dinner?
I mean, I can't base off of someone's DM and their profile, right? So obviously, look, if I was not a celebrity, I would totally do that dating apps. What are they called? Tinder?
There's like Raya, which is more of like
Oh, you've been on it?
Oh, yeah, I'm on Raya.
Oh, is it? Has anything
happened from it? No, I can't follow up on Raya.
Oh, okay.
Like, we'll match, and then like then you're able to like message each other, and from there it doesn't go anywhere. Like, I've never met in person. Like, I've matched with a few people, you know? But it hasn't led to anything.
Oh, okay. I mean, if I wasn't a celebrity, I would totally do that. So I was thinking, like, using my friend's face doing that.
But they're going to be like, surprise.
No, and then it's like, surprise, you get something better.
Jesus.
I'm totally kidding.
Damn, just roasted your friend.
I'm totally kidding. I'm totally kidding. But
yeah.
That's how hard it is and desperate I am. And like, it's like, I just want love. Like, I want to, you know, I don't think it's wrong to like want love.
It's not.
You know, and like compassion and just like real love.
Just settle for like. No.
Or lust.
Yeah,
no,
or
no,
lust.
No lust. I ain't got time for none of that shit. I just want love.
You ain't got time for lust?
I mean, lust could turn into love, right?
That, yeah, true.
Yeah, so.
Yeah.
Do your friends try to matchmake for you?
My friends are f***ing assholes. Like, I always tell them, hey, if you ever go out, because I don't go out. I don't drink, nothing. So I always tell my friends, if you see anyone that's a good candidate, like just like a little bit,
yeah,
let me know.
Mm.
Or let them know. Or just like make it very like casual. None of them hit me up.
So it could be like a dental assistant and you're cool with that.
I mean,
as long as they're nice and have the features.
It's
that you're
not even
for.
About being nice. You have to have humor. I mean, there comes along a lot with it. Like, but obviously, I just like a guy who's
masculine.
No, it's not even masculine. It's like the energy. I don't know. I can't really explain it. I can't even explain masculinity. It's not about, back in the days, I used to like gangsters, you know, like. I thought at that time that was masculine, but then I realized, oh my God, dating these people come with like so much baggage, you know? And like, I have so much to lose by dating these people. So then I grew up and I dated like maybe seven guys, and they were all very long.
Right.
Very long. So, you know, now I'm in a place where I'm looking for love. If I meet a guy, I'm actually gonna try to marry this person.
Wow.
Rather than just like have like a little fling with them or something.
Wow, so this
like
is
that.
Like a big decision in the last couple
years.
Yeah,
so if anybody here is.
I think if you wanna come back to TV, a dating show would be amazing.
That would be amazing.
Okay,
to watch,
so guys, let me tell you guys a story. So, somebody wants to do like a Netflix series with me, and I'm not really a big fan of like doing all those like reality TV shows because I've done a lot.
Yeah.
But I was like, somebody needs to do like a Finding Jessi Love like type of show. That would be cool. Cause remember back in the day, like Attila Tequila, what's his name?
Shot at Love Tequila.
Shot at Love It. And what's the other guy?
Flavor Flav.
Yeah. That was my favorite show.
Flavor of Love, classic.
Yeah.
But I mean, obviously that shit is like fake at the end cause nobody really ends up together, but who knows?
So yeah, you would do something like that.
I really would.
I agree.
You
like
might
the shit
need
out of
something.
That.
Yeah, that would be that's, so entertaining.
It would be, and it'd be so weird too at the same time. But for me, like, whatever it is, like,
I'd go on the show, like, surprise.
I give you a chance.
They're showing me the money chain on me. I'm just like, okay.
Yeah, we have to come up with like a funny send off. Like,
no. So someone has actually in Hollywood has. Offered, I actually came up with the concept. I was like, hey, this is what I think it'd be really entertaining. It's also good for me.
That should get green.
And they were like, bro, this is like the best idea ever because no Koreans would do that. You know what I mean?
You don't think a lot of Korean women celebrities would go through along with the show? Is it a little bit?
I mean,
could be a little nerve wracking.
I don't think I would do it in Korea. I think I would do it in like,
oh, really?
Okay. Maybe I would do it in like like Italy or like Greece or like America. Yeah. I don't know. Just not Korea.
Got you. Anyway, when you're talking about like dating, are you talking a lot of time? Doesn't matter if they're like Korean or Korean American or like a different ethnic group. Like you're over here and living out here. So it'd probably be somebody more local, right? Because you've done like long distance stuff.
Yeah, I've done a lot of long distance.
That's tough.
It's not. Long distance, like I actually prefer that sometimes because when I'm really busy, it gets, I actually like feeling that feeling where I can't see that person in a really long time. And then when you're like so busy and you miss that person so much and you're like waiting, you get those butterflies in your stomach. And then when you see them, it's like you've never, it's like when you guys first met. So I actually like that and I actually prefer it. But now I don't really know what I want, but I think I'll know when I see that person,
long,
you know?
Long distance messes up people's schedules. Because, like, you know, I've dated somebody from long distance and, like, different time zones.
And also the trust issue. Yeah.
Well, nowadays, I think the trust is fucked up because me, I'm very old school. So I'm all about, like, if I have a man, I'm, like, all for my man. Mm. But, like, everybody's cheating. I just don't fucking understand. Mm. What the fuck is going on?
You think more people are cheating now?
Everybody. Girls, men, everybody.
It's harder to cheat now.
What do you mean?
Because they got geotags.
I know so many people around me. I know
CCTV and everywhere. They got CCTV everywhere, bro.
They got it everywhere. And like they have the phone apps where they can like see, what's that thing? That app, like where they could see your location.
Yeah, find your phone.
I don't know anything like that. So I'm just like.
She's ideal to cheat on because she doesn't not tech savvy, guys. No, I'm kidding.
No, but like I literally just. For me, none of that matters. Like, I just want to find somebody, you know? Like, I don't have a life. Like, I just work, go home. I work at home, and then I go back to work.
Well, would that change at some point? Would you be like, I'm going to do a year of not performing, not working on anything? Would that ever happen, you think, for yourself?
I mean, I'm pretty sure it will happen one day, but as you know, COVID just ended.
Right.
Now all the festivals are here.
You're trying to hit the ground running.
Yeah, and like so there are a lot of shows festivals that contact me, but now I pick and choose. So like before I would be like, I'm going to do it all because I had so much energy and like I went to, but now I'm like, let me think of my health. Let me chill the fuck out. Let me just like do like two shows max a week.
Did you just do a size show recently?
Oh yeah, like 2 days ago. That was like the funniest thing because like he literally just calls me and just like out of nowhere and just like,
and next thing hey. You're in front of like 20,000 people.
No, not even 80,000 people.
That's crazy.
I went there. 80,000? I was like, damn, Sayo, but you still got it.
People. That's crazy.
Yeah, because it was in Seoul. Because Seoul is like the main, but like it was so funny because Sayo called me. Me, like no matter what, even though I left P Nation, whether it was for good or bad, I still have my loyalty with Sayopa. You know what I mean? Like, he's held me down. Even though, you know, we've had our, like, whatever. Like, I am still loyal to him. Right. He's still the same with me. So when he asked me to do that, he called me out of nowhere. And I already knew what he wanted. I already knew. I was like, what's up, Opa? And he's like, Jessi야, 한번 복수 와줘라. And I was like, I got you. So for me, it was like a good, more than a good experience. I've done it twice now. I like helping people, you know?
Is Sai's show kind of like, it's his annual festival almost?
It is.
Like his own concert is a festival in itself, right?
So I know like people who aren't even fans of Sai and don't know a lot of his music that just want to go there because the festival's just like all water. So you know how like right now water bomb's like the thing right now, right? It's kind of like that. Like they just want to go there to have fun and get wet and like their titties out and their fucking, you know what I mean? I mean, I don't know if their titties
out. The Sai demographic though is like all ages. It's like pretty much all of Korea.
It's from like 10 years old to like maybe like I've seen somebody like when I was on stage, like I'm really good at making eye contact.
Yeah.
There were people that were like 70 years old there.
What's like the U.S. equivalent, you think, of Sai?
U.S. equivalent to Sai?
Equivalent of Sai?
Well, just somebody that's still got it. Like
similar to, as an artist.
Not sonically, but just that kind of.
There's no one. Sai, like I feel like with Sai, with his humpok show, right? It's called Somewhere Swag. I think that's what it's called. What is humpok show?
I don't know.
I don't know.
It must be shortened for something, right? Because it sounds like humpok show.
I don't know.
All right? It's got to be shortened for something. But anyways, regardless, that festival, he created that. Like, he did the production. He does everything for that. So he's the one who started the whole water festival. So that's like his like own thing that he has forever.
That's cool. So every year he just does this. Yeah. He tours that all across Korea.
All around Korea. I heard like last year he had 7. Now he has 12. So it's like, damn.
It's like you're talking probably reaching about 1 million people live.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
And people just want tickets all around me because it's not because they're like, I don't want to see Psy. I just want to see the water. I just want to see the vibes. And he performs really well.
So I looked up the tickets and he's on tour, right? He's going to Busan, Daegu, like all these cities across Korea. And every show has like less than 10 tickets left to each venue. Yeah. That's like 80,000 each.
Yeah. So it goes up to, well, Jamshid is the one in Seoul is the biggest one because they did Jamshid Stadium. The capacity goes up to like 100,000 people. But the other ones, I think they're less because the stadiums are a lot smaller. The arenas are smaller, but it's still very successful. Like,
would you like to perform when you get to that age?
No.
You would not want to perform?
Listen, I don't know how he did it. So that day, I performed 3 songs, right? Yeah. I was so out of breath. I don't know if it was because of all the people or all the fog and the water. I'm just like, even my dancers were dying. And I'm like, something in that stadium, it just makes you really drained. Like, you're just like, hold on, let me drink some water. I'm like fucking coughing and shit. Like,
I mean, you could argue Psy is the greatest Korean performer of all time, right?
Even till this day, even though that I did leave P Nation, I can still stand here very confidently saying that Psy is one of the best production-wise. He's so good at creativity, like just everything, like lighting.
Right.
He's a perfectionist.
And he's hands-on with everything?
Everything.
Yeah.
The only thing that I didn't like about working with him was he was just too involved in everything.
Yeah.
But when I saw his show in a really long time, I was just like, damn, this guy's like so much older than me and he's still fucking performing. He's like dancing like a beast.
Yeah. Yeah.
And he does like a 2-hour and 30-minute show. That's crazy.
That's insane.
That's like props to him, man. He's fucking nobody.
Shout out Psy, the GOAT, man. That is
GOAT. He's a fucking GOAT.
Yeah.
You be throwing out GOATs too much, bro. I be hearing he's always like, everyone that comes out, he's like,
that's true. Everyone can't be the GOAT.
He's like, Koala, yeah, you the GOAT.
There is no way I ever said that. No offense to Koala, but I've never said he's the GOAT.
No, but you will somehow use that word into something, like to somebody.
Man, I'm going to chill. Now I'm going to be self-conscious saying GOAT. No, he's the GOAT, though.
I honestly don't like using that word because I don't think they're GOATs. Like, you can't consider I've seen a podcast of you. You always call everyone a GOAT.
All right, you're the GOAT.
The GOAT of K-pop.
You are the GOAT, though.
The GOAT of K-rap. The GOAT of K-drama. The GOAT of, you know.
You are one of the GOATs of Korea.
No, I'm not. I'm still... You know what's really weird? I've really humbled myself. Like, I feel like I still have a lot to go. There's a lot of things that I feel like I need to do.
There's a little bit of a difference to you. Like, I just saw you after seeing you probably in a year or so. And
is it my fringe?
Something's different about you.
Is it the aura?
Overall appearance and aura is more positive, I feel like.
I try to be positive. I'm actually negative as fuck inside.
Because I'm actually a very negative kind of dude.
I know. But I'm very different negative now,
but I've changed a lot too.
Have you?
Yeah, I'm less bitter. I'm super positive.
Yeah,
like Zoe recently saw me after being sober and he was like, Dumb's actually a delight to be around. That's what he said.
Delight.
He's more positive now since I've been
sober.
You call
everybody goats.
Definitely. It's annoying.
It's annoying.
No, because you know, back in the days, like, Dumb is always so fun to be with, but sometimes there's like a time limit with him. Mm. Like, it's like, there's a point where you just want to like get the fuck out because he just like gets crazy, right? But now, I watch his podcast. He's not only gotten wiser, but he's very like kind to people. And I don't know. It's something about you too. Your aura. You've grown.
I used to be grumpy. I think that's the word. I was really grumpy
for no reason.
Yeah.
I'm like, what do you do, bro? Like, why are you so grumpy all the time?
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, like,
actually, for you, you're actually a very happy person, you know?
I would say I am. Like, I try. I don't like to be a negative person to people. Like, when in a room full of a lot of people, I don't like to be so negative, you know? But then when I go home, I'll be all like sad and cry in my room, like a fucking baby. But
do you have a lot of alone time?
Yeah. I don't have any friends.
You got friends.
I mean, I do, but like when I mean friends is like, I have a problem. I realized as I got older, I have a problem with not being able to talk about my problems to people. And what I do is, like the other day, yesterday, somebody called me and they asked me for like counseling for their problems. And I'm really good at giving advice, but it's like, who's going to hear me out, you know? But then when I try to talk to someone, I don't want to hear it.
Yeah.
I'm like, what do you know? What do you know about my f-ing life, you know?
Oh, you don't want to hear their advice.
No, I do, but sometimes it just doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
Like, they'll just be like, you can do it, Jess. You've been doing it. Like, you're a strong girl.
I definitely think you need somebody to talk to, you personally.
100%.
Because I'll shoot Jessi a text, and you'll get 50 texts back. You know what I mean? And it feels like you want to talk to somebody.
I'm a really bad texter, but not only that, when I text back, I have so much just
thoughts
in my head that I just
dump it.
Yeah. I just throw it up. Like, I'm literally like, hey, dumb, so what are you doing? So like, so how is this? So it's not one paragraph. I'll just say it in like text, like words.
Yeah, that's when I'm grateful for an LOL. I'm like, LOL.
And I'm like, this bastard. I just like poured out my heart and he just said LOL.
Just throwing a duck that goes like this.
Yeah, but one thing I love about Dumb so much is like he never changes. And like I feel like when I first met Dumb, like back in the days, I thought he was a complete fucking asshole.
Mm, really?
I think I saw you at a club in K-Town. Yeah. I don't club anymore, but I think that was the first time I heard about you and I saw you. I loved you when you freestyled. And then when I saw you, I was like, oh my God, this guy, I think you were drunk. That's why.
Yeah, sounds good.
And you were just like all over the place and like just trying to like hit on girls and they were all just saying no to you.
What the hell? They were saying no.
No, I mean, it was because I was with like Tiny Oban then. Right, it was that club.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Do you know what I'm talking about? I think
I know. It's so funny that that's the part you disputed. She was like, you're hitting on girls and they were saying no to you. They didn't say no to me.
No, because that crowd of girls was not like Dumb style, I don't think. It was very like Korean. It was really weird that day in LA.
I don't know if that's necessarily my type of girl.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I don't think maybe you were like hitting on them, but
yeah. I don't even know if I have a type. If I look at like a lineup of like all the girls I've dated, they look all different.
You know what's so crazy? I've asked my friends, I'm like, hey, what's your type? My friends all say they don't have a type anymore. They're just like, I like what I like.
Is there like a age limit up that you said mostly
I like older men.
Yeah, but like how older? How?
I mean, there's no preference, but I feel like
you wouldn't date like a Samchon age, you know?
What's the Samchon like? 40?
Actually, not too far off. I guess we can say we're.
Oh my God!
No, like, I'm saying, well, yeah.
You know, I love that I'm aging. Like, I wouldn't ever go back to. You know how nowadays everyone's like super young? They're like 21. They're like born in the 2000s, and I'm just like, I would never want to go back to that age.
I would say you look even better than 10 years ago.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, some say I do too, but.
No, you do. So, Dumb.
I was hoping to hurt you would reciprocate.
No,
that,
this is what me and Dumb have like a very thing in common. Well, I think this goes for a lot of people. I had a very old face when I was young. Mm. So did Dumb.
I did. We had the case of the old face.
Mine wasn't as severe, but I used to love.
Jesus. Okay, sorry. You sound like I'm a burn victim or something. Severe.
No, you were severe, but you had like the mustache. So I feel like you like to look older and you have the masculine features. Like you have like.
No, but I know what you mean though. We looked older like when we were young. Yeah, so when we
so
get
you
older.
Grew into your face.
We grew into our face.
Yeah, and now you look like younger, like your face stayed the same, you know what I mean? And I feel like I don't know how I look, to be honest. I'm like so self-conscious with my face these days. Like, that's why I cut my bangs. Like, I'm trying to hide my face right now.
You look great. Like the bangs good.
You like it?
Yeah.
I actually did it because I was like,
looks a little more innocent, I would say.
Yeah, I'm trying to go for the more innocent vibe.
You still got the big hoop earrings though, which is still kind
of, I don't, but today,
oh, Jenny from the block,
I you know? Didn't really wear any jewelry, so I just,
yeah,
I don't really care about the appearance and stuff like that. I used to be so into that, so over it. Like, I used to like shop a lot. I haven't shopped in like 2 years.
Yeah, you've been very low key, I think.
Yeah, I think the past 2 years have been a very life changing experience for me, and I'm.
Was there one traumatic experience that happened in particular, or no? It was just like, I mean, you don't have to share exactly.
No,
but is there something that really made you shift your lifestyle a little bit?
Oh, I've shifted a lot. Stupid ass. They're like trying to sell me something. I don't know. I've had, you know, not only has the industry, because I've been doing this for 18 years now. I've noticed. Wow. It's like 18년.
Yeah, yeah. It's crazy, 18 right? years. 18 years.
18 years. And I don't think I ever got to celebrate my life. You know, do you get what I'm saying? Like, I never got to celebrate my success and
like sit down and breathe. Yeah,
and
in.
Like breathe. And just, I was just working, working, working. And I kind of lost myself. And I was in that hole. And once you get in that hole, you just can't get out. And I'm so independent, meaning like, I don't talk about my problems to my friends or my family. So my friends check up on me and I'm always like, I'm good. Mm. Or like, you know, I pretend like nothing's wrong with me. But these days, like, I feel like I'm crying for help. But like, I don't know who to talk to because that's just not how I am. I'm not used to talking to people like that.
Right.
You know, talking about my problems and be like, hey, like, you know what I mean? Like, so I think like, I've lost a lot of people in the past 2 years, and I think it made me realize a lot, like, wow, life is really short, and like, people just around you that you love just disappear, can disappear in one day. Mm. You wake up and they're gone, and like, I think I lost like a good 9 people.
Like cutting them off? Or
no, just they passed away.
Oh.
And as I was so busy that I was sad, but like I had to hide it. You know what I mean? Because I was working and I'm doing TV and like I'm, you know, I can't cry about it, you know? So I think it's really important when you're like, so this is what I wanted to talk about. Like, I don't know in how it is. I heard that in America, like you guys talk about mental health a lot, right?
Definitely.
It's not really talked about in Korea. Mm. People don't talk about mental health out here. You know, they just take meds and they get prescribed medicine.
So a lot of the variety shows and stuff, that's not a topic that's brought up a lot?
No, never, because it's very like, I wouldn't say it's frowned upon, but it's
still
more,
taboo, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, I've spent some time out here when she was going through her everyday kind of schedule. Mm. And it's pretty intense. Like, I've seen it from like the morning to the end, you know. And I think in Korea, it's interesting because far as shows, you can pack in a lot of shows in one day. You know, like in America, if you're on a festival, it's usually that festival for the rest of the day. Correct. Over here, it's like you can do like 3-4 concerts and then go to like 2 festivals, making it, you're hopping on other people's sets.
Yeah.
What's like the most amount of shows you've done in a day?
I think 4.
4, yeah.
So
and these are like big shows.
Yeah, so I would do variety. And then during variety TV, I would go out for a second, do a show.
Like a live performance?
Yeah. And then come back to the variety show. They would wait for me. And then at night, I would do another show. And then I would do like another performance at night, like midnight. But once I did that one, I was like, fuck this shit. I'm never doing this shit again. Like, fuck the money. Like, I'm not about, right now, everything that I do, I'm just like, it's not about the money anymore. It's about my health. I got to get mentally straight, like, for me to... Like, without your health, you ain't shit. Mm-hmm. Like, you can't do no shows, right? So I now balance everything out and just, like, make sure that I do, like, a show or 2 shows a week and then, like, rest and kind of reflect and just, like, tell yourself you're good.
Yeah.
And pray and, like, I'm very spiritual these days.
Are you?
Yeah. I'm very different from your last podcast, right?
Yeah, I don't know.
Well, that was
energy's
also,
a little different. I'm different too.
But look, I think everyone changes. I change like every like 2-3 months. Like it's not my personality. I'm a deep thinker. So
I mean health has been a very key thing for me too.
Yeah, I've noticed
I was really unhealthy for a while, like mentally, physically. Yeah. But no, I was very functional. Like I knew how to live the very unhealthy lifestyle. Right. Drinking every night, you know, out being outside, but like I'd still wake up and do this, you know, but I don't think I was doing it at the best capacity. Like now I know I'm like optimal.
Yeah.
You know,
I think that's great. I think like, you know, with Dumb, it's very interesting because he's only here for 5 days and he's like, hey, Jess, you want to do a podcast? Like, it's like, of course, you know, for me, it's like, but it's like the fact that he's out here. So he can relax, but he's still trying to throw
create
work
content.
That's fucking dope, bro. Like, you know, I was going to pull out last minute, but I was like, nah, I can't do that this time. I'm just kidding.
I always pull out last minute. No, I'm kidding.
That's what that he said.
I had to take that one. That was easy right there. I was going to say, yeah, it's really crazy because I think during the pandemic is really when I saw kind of the global impact that you've had with your music. Yeah, because people knew you as this figure from Korea, you know, very outspoken as a female artist.
Yeah.
But so all of a sudden I started hearing your song so globally, like virality on TikTok with Zoom. And then on She-Hulk, which is like a Disney production.
Yeah.
They played her song Zoom on there.
Yeah.
Like she's dancing, singing along to the song, you know?
So, you know, it's actually, I'm very blessed. During the pandemic, so I think it was right before I signed with P Nation. So like right after a podcast.
Yeah.
I was like, yes, I'm starting over. Da, da, da. And like, I was in LA for a little bit and I was trying to sign deals with like American record deals, like companies, right? And I was just like, and then all of a sudden the pandemic hit, the fucking corona, whatever, right? So I ended up not being able to stay in America and sign these deals, right? So I ended up going back to Korea. I'm like, wow, my fucking luck. I came to Korea. I dropped the song, Who That Be. It did okay, but I'm actually, that's one of my favorite songs. It's just because of the lyrics and just, it's who I am, right? And I'm just like, no, I'm going to drop another song. And I dropped, and that's when I dropped Nunu Nana.
Yeah.
Now, Nunu Nana was not supposed to do well. It wasn't my cup of tea.
Yeah.
Like, it wasn't something that I loved, but with the beat that I had to make a melody. And like, I was just like, oh my God, I was in the studio for like 4 or 5 days trying to make the song not so freaking like poppy, where it still has my like authentic self. And then Sai was like, we got to shoot the video. And then like, right after I was about to shoot the video, Hyori Eunni hit me up and was like, can you be in Refund Sisters? I was like, what the fuck is going on?
Yeah.
So I was like, this is like the hottest show. So I was like, okay, so I'm going to be in a group and then I'm going to drop this. So I was like, Hyori Eunni, is it okay if you come in my video?
Yeah.
Like, I want you to be the OG. She's the GOAT. Now that's a GOAT, right?
Yeah, yeah.
She's the GOAT. I was like, I just want you to be in the ending. That's it. Like, you just being like the boss, you know, you're the boss of me, you know? And then she loved the song. And then I did Refund Sisters. And right after that, I just kept doing so many variety shows.
Yeah.
So from there, my never stop. So if you think about it, I'm super blessed because during COVID, that was my highest, like that was my peak.
Right, right.
You know, like that was the first time I was on charts and I was like almost, I was at number two. You know what's so crazy? Because my shit was slowly going up, like really slow on Melon. And then right when I was about to get to one, I was at number two, right? Which was impossible. Like everybody was on there. BTS came out. I was at number two. And then it was like changing.
You almost felt that you were about to get that one.
No, I was going to. But I heard BTS was coming out. I was like, goddamn, right? But then, you know what? I was like, what's the point of being the number one? I felt so good being on the chart with BTS.
Yeah,
like right under BTS. It felt great.
Right, right, right.
And then right after that, Blackpink came out. I was like, whatever.
You're like, I'm never going to get there.
Yeah, I'm never going to get there. But I realized, God, why does everyone want to be number one? You know what I mean? It's like, what do you get from that?
More problems. That's what you get.
And it just makes you, like, every song that you drop, you're like, I want to be number one. I want to be on number top 10. Like, just so much pressure. And like, I think that's where it slowly got fucked up. That's when I started music that was like ear friendly and like pop music. I kept catering to the pop.
Oh, so you were trying to hit number one by like.
Not to necessarily hit number one. I just wanted people to remember the song by like just making catchy music. And that's where I kind of lost myself.
Yeah, that's what I've been saying my whole career. Who cares about number one?
But you
what's wrong with number 127? What's wrong with it?
But I think all the music that I was dropping, it was doing really well. And now the funny thing about Zoom is I made that in 2 days. Yeah. So how that song came out was it was an archive song. So we had that like a year like before, right? And I just did, I see you looking at my pee. I was going to say P-U. So P-I-C was like, I said it like P-U-S-S-I. You know, like it almost sounds like you're about. It was kind of like that. But then I was like, all right, let's make it PG. PG-13, right? 15.
But that intro was just like,
for Zoom.
You just hear it everywhere.
You know what I thought? I was like, this song is so annoying, right? Because, you know, I was in the studio. I kept redoing, I see you, because like I wanted that one sound, right. You know? Dang it, dang it, jump to dang it. But like, there was a sound that I wanted.
Yeah.
I changed the verse like a million times. And then I told Sia I want the second verse to be a completely different beat because it's just too much. It's like so loud. And yeah. Like, I feel like my voice is an instrument, so I don't need too much music, like, instruments.
You want minimal.
Minimum.
Yeah.
Because my voice is so loud and like it's strong, right? So I didn't do any promotion at all with that song. And
so it naturally did well on TikTok.
But deep down in my heart, I knew the song was going to do on TikTok because the song is about a picture. We all live for pictures, right?
Yeah.
So I knew that it wasn't going to do well, but I was like, let me just give it a try and just write everything about TikTok.
Yeah.
And just like pictures and stuff. So a week later, I got 4.5 million views. 4.5 million people used that
sharing the sound. Yeah.
And that's, you know, they say that after like 25,000 people use your songs, that's when they know it's going to kind of succeed.
And this is 4.5 million
users.
And that's crazy. Sia was doing that.
She-Hulk, the show, Marvel, they used your song. And I thought it was interesting because some would say you're like a very She-Hulk figure in Korea. You know, like a strong woman. Not like, you know what I mean? Like a strong...
I get what you mean.
Strong superhero-ish woman. So absolutely. I feel like the creators of the show kind of saw that and paired up almost like a certain artist and song for this character. That's how I see it. I really did see it.
I do
like that.
Because I actually saw the producer's interview. Mm-hmm. She's Korean, right?
No, she's Chinese. Jessica Gao.
Her name was Jessica.
That's the homie. Yeah.
She actually like said that she like loved me and my character and the song and everything. And I think that's what she was kind of feeling too. And I felt so blessed. Like I was like, God, like, thank you. Like this is like such a an honor, you know?
Yeah.
And I love the Hulk.
Yeah.
And then like She-Hulk was huge, right?
Yeah.
So I remember at that time when they used a song, I didn't know that that song was going to be on She-Hulk.
Yeah.
So nobody fucking told me about it. And then all of a sudden I look at Instagram, everyone's talking about it.
Yeah.
And then I was just like, I was just super grateful.
You're the She-Hulk of K-pop.
I mean, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a good thing.
Yeah, I mean...
I definitely have that, like, She-Hulk energy, you know what I mean?
You're strong as hell. I will say that. I mean,
physically, I've gotten a lot weaker. I used to be able to do, like, 30 push-ups. Now I only could do, like, 5.
She just might mess around and, like...
I'll
crack a joke and she'll just, like, hit me.
You bully dumb?
Yeah. I'm, like, one of those people who, like, laugh and just, like...
And it hurts. Like, it hurts.
Dubs legit gets mad. He's, like, that really hurt.
Yeah.
Like, all my other guy friends, they're just, like... They're just like a man, so they're just like, oh, yeah.
That's why I'm not funny.
Other friends are like, man. Like,
Jess, that really hurt.
That's why I'm not funny around her because I don't want to get slapped. Was there ever a fit that you wore on like Korean television or media that someone was like, you got to chill? Like, or did you ever push a boundary in that way where somebody would?
Actually, we were actually just talking about this. So I think it was a Waterbomb that blew up.
So Waterbomb, for people who are tuned in and aren't familiar, it's a festival during the summer, a music festival. There's water guns and everything. You're splashing the audience.
God, it's the worst. It's like, it's beautiful. Like,
it's fun.
Performing.
Yeah.
The event is amazing, but the artist is so difficult because everyone has in the front row has water guns. These water guns are so accurate.
Wait, they shoot the performers?
They spray your eye and your nose. It's like
everyone's splashing each other. It's a water fest.
Yeah, but still.
But it's like, bro, I'm performing and they're like splashing they're directly spraying it in your eye.
Yeah.
So when you go home, you have water in every hole. Yeah, yo. Your whole, everything is wet. Yeah. You get every what I'm orifice. Saying? And like, it's just like, doesn't feel good, but you know, it's always fun, you know, for the people. I do it for the people and it's like.
Wait, so there was an outfit you wore that got.
So this is one of the things, I don't want to say it out of my mouth, but it went viral because I don't usually have a stylist when it comes to like festivals, but there was this one time I wore this mesh like dress, right?
Was it orange?
Wait, no.
Okay, because I went last year. I was there.
Yeah, that wasn't even that bad. Okay. But, okay, I have a photo, okay? This is what changed the whole standard because I was like, everyone at Waterbomb was still like dressing like this, you know, just normal. Like,
right.
You right? But I was like, it's a fucking Waterbomb. I've been doing this for so long. Might as well just wear a fucking bikini. So I was the first one to wear a bikini.
Oh, like just actual. Yeah. No one was wearing a bikini at the Waterfest.
I don't even think Jay Park took his shirt off.
Yeah.
That was the first time that I actually like was like naked. Like I was like, this shit, I'm gonna wear a bra. Like,
yeah.
Cause I'm gonna get wet anyways, right? And it's a Waterbomb.
Okay, well, let's see the picture.
All right, calm down. I'm finding it. So it was a weep, but I remember this was all over headlines, and then people actually liked it after. I was getting a lot of hate, and then they were like, wow, she's like breaking standards, you know?
Let's see it.
I'm looking for all it. Right. Oh, God damn, this was so long.
Text it over or something. Okay.
There you go. But don't put that one up.
He had it saved as a screensaver, which is crazy.
Wow, you had it on your...
Oh, this is nice.
No, pretty. But what happened was...
This is hot. This is pretty hot. This like is this would be considered...
Like a mesh.
Would this be considered pretty edgy for Korea right here? It would...
Okay,
right.
But look.
But there's a thong,
What
too.
You don't understand...
Oh, there's
about,
a thong. You can see...
This is
a mesh.
No, here's a better one.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
so,
I see.
I did not know that I was... I knew I was wearing a thong and a bra, but this, what happened was, it was all together. It's a mesh dress. It's like when you go to the pool.
Yeah.
But I didn't realize all this water was going to hit me, and then the mesh was like falling, so all the holes were falling apart. That's why you can see my ass.
Yeah.
You know, every little fucking thing that... Why are you zooming in?
I'm reading some of the comments here. People in the comments saying it's not nice of her to show her buttocks, but I can't seem to see. My eyes is broken. What the hell? What does that mean?
Yeah, so like a lot of these kids are like obviously children.
And it says, 대박, 섹시해, 미쳤나봐. Yeah, okay. I mean, it is pretty sexy for, I think, for Korea. Like,
Shout out to the photographer because he actually got really good photos because usually they don't take good photos of me because they don't. It seems as if, but yeah, this is the photo.
Yeah, we'll put it on.
Yeah,
the
screen.
So what year?
Body.
What year was that?
I had a great body.
Jessi, what year?
That was 2018.
Okay.
2018. We'll put the link right here. Okay. Yeah,
put it up. You know what? Literally.
That's the thumbnail, actually.
That's the thumbnail. Yeah, there you go.
To be honest, guys, like, I don't care. I don't, like, back in the days, I used to, from I'm Pretty Rap Star, you know how I didn't give a fuck, right? Mm. That was when I didn't give a fuck because I really didn't give a fuck at that time.
Yeah.
I was like, I'm fucking done with this shit, right? But now... I'm trying to be more like, now I know like the boundaries of like what's too much and what's like, you know, so I wouldn't wear something.
Well,
like
let me ask you, would you ever do a tasteful nude shoot?
For like, myself, yes.
But not on a like a magazine publication.
Like a Playboy?
Yeah, like, you know, Playboy was like, you know,
OnlyFans?
No, but I'm saying like Playboy used to do very tasteful shoots too, you know?
Right,
so,
no, Playboy.
Like, would you do an artistic nude shoot?
I mean, how much money are you talking?
Okay. Or like swimsuit does like body additions, you know, like body.
I had a magazine in Korea that was like health, and they wanted me to wear a bikini.
I mean, Sports Illustrated, my bad.
Yeah, it was one of those.
Yeah.
I said no because it wasn't very tasteful. Like the magazine, like it was a very big magazine. I forgot the name, but. The way they wanted me to like do it, like they wanted just me straight up in a bikini and the, like, you know, like I felt like there's a time and place for it. Maybe when I get older, maybe like I'm never going to have this body for the rest of my life, you know, so might as well embrace it, you know, but I haven't had an opportunity. I've never thought of that.
Right.
But maybe for my boyfriend, maybe one day, like I'll have like,
I mean, that's easy. Cause it's just between you and your boyfriend.
I don't send like nude photos to people.
Right.
I don't.
Right.
I don't even do that to my boyfriends. I don't do that because I just.
You just send the link to that.
Screenshot that.
Yeah, yeah.
No, I just think it's like weird. Like it's just like, why would I? You know.
So there's things that you are shy about.
I'm very shy.
Yeah.
Where would you like your career to be and your life to be at 40? That's like, you know, 5 years or so from
Oh, that's so sad.
Well, you're the one who mentioned it.
Look, you know what's so crazy? 2 days ago, I had a dream that I was 5 months pregnant, and I didn't know who the baby daddy was.
That's specific, though. 5 months?
Yeah, so 5 months, to be specific.
And you didn't know who the baby daddy was?
I didn't know who the baby daddy was, and I didn't care. I just wanted that baby.
In your dream.
Yeah, I was so happy, and everybody was like, who's the baby daddy? I was like, I don't know. I don't even think I had sex. And I remember I was like holding my stomach and I was so happy and I was crying.
Yeah.
I just wanted.
Wow.
So it was in my dream. So it's like, I really want a baby. You know, I love my nieces. Like, I like love them so much. Like, I literally live for my nieces. Like, but I think in 5 years, hopefully I will become, you know,
a mom.
And, you know, who knows? Like I said, I want to start acting, you know, I want to own my own business, you know, start my own company one day. And there's a lot of things I want to do. I want to write a book. I want to write a children's book, actually, because I love children so much. So I'm like, oh my God. And I want to make a children's song, like shark.
What would your children's song be about? Like, what kind of message would you want to get across children?
I mean, what message is okay? Like shark doo 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 doo. Right? What's the song called?
I guess there isn't a message.
It's just that melody is so good, and I'm so good with melodies. Yeah. And I feel like I would make a really good song like that.
Yeah.
And that shit always works.
Don't let them bully you. Fight back. Violence is okay sometimes.
Violence is sometimes the answer.
Yeah.
No, but like, I think, like, I don't know. I really want to write a book. Something with Channing Tatum came out with a book. Did you know that?
Well, yeah, I think I read something about
After he had a daughter,
yeah.
He, like, the cover, I forgot what the name of the book was.
Don't become a stripper like me and Magic Mike.
Oh, my God. Have you seen that movie?
No, of course, Magic Mike, yeah, yeah. Donnie's favorite, actually.
No, but he wrote a book, and he was wearing, a tiara.
Yeah.
And, like, people were like, what the right? But then he did it because that's what his daughter wanted him. Like,
right, right.
So he wrote a book strictly for his daughter. Mm-hmm. And like, it was so touching. I don't know why. Like, the book made no sense at all. It literally made no sense, but it was, I just felt it, you know, like the love for his child. And I was just like, wow, like, this is what I wanted. I wanted to write a book.
I feel like children's songs have the potential. I mean, they get like the most views and listeners.
Yeah.
Because kids just play it on loop and over again.
My niece be listening to Shark Doodoo. What's that song called?
Baby Shark.
Oh, Baby Shark. You know that song is actually made by
Koreans. And we talked about it on this pod with Jay last time.
Yeah, and I'm like, bro, like Koreans are good at everything.
Make your kid song. I like it.
I think because all my friends have kids and they're always listening to the same songs, right? I'm like, this song is so good. And
yeah.
Like,
oh, you know, Rick's having a baby.
Whoa, that's a secret, bro.
No, because the episode, he's announcing the baby's coming out this week. So.
Oh, my God.
This will be after. Yeah, Rick's having a baby.
Is he married?
He's going to get married, yeah.
I'm going to cry.
Yeah, yeah. Rick's baby's 5 months old, 5 months so far.
She's
5 months pregnant, I mean.
Oh, congrats, Rick. Yeah, oh, my God.
He's going to be a good dad, I think, too.
He's going to see, people like Rick are the people who become great dads.
Yeah, maybe that was what your dream was about. Because you were 5 months pregnant and she's 5 months pregnant.
Okay.
So you were holding Rick's baby. No,
took a twist.
Yeah,
took
a twist.
Stop it.
Okay, no, but.
Wow.
Yeah. Does that make you emotional or what?
Yeah. I mean, I'm so happy for him. Yeah. Like, look, at the end of the day, like, you know what I realized? Like, I'm at a place where I just want all my friends to win. I'm so happy for Dom. Like, every time I see him, I don't see him, but I see him on, like, line and stuff. And, like, the things that he does, like, I'm just so proud of him. Like, even on my other friends, like, I see them winning and I'm like, so happy for them. And yeah. usually people are so bitter about it or they're jealous, right? But I'm just like literally so happy for them.
Yeah.
You know, and like I'm getting mature.
Well, you know? If you ever never find a partner to have a baby with and you freeze your eggs, but you need a sperm donor.
Yeah.
I'd be happy to sacrifice my sperm.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah. Like, I mean, I have good qualities, I think. I'm not saying I'd be the best father,
Maybe. I like it.
If you don't need me to be in your life, I could at least just give you the sperm. So, though,
like,
you know what I mean?
I actually thought about, like, getting the whole freezing my eggs and stuff like right. that. I looked into it. I actually want a mixed baby.
Right, right.
A mixed baby because...
I was born in Argentina. I don't know if that counts, but I was. I mean, it's true. You couldn't Wikipedia it.
No, but you know what? Dumb has really good features. Like, he has really good features. Like, your niece is so cute.
That's what you can expect, yeah.
Very but she's
cute.
Mixed.
Very cute, she's very smart. Mixed. That's true, that's true.
She's yeah. like the perfect mix of your sister and the husband.
That's
like,
true, that's true.
I always watch, I'm like, oh my gosh, she's so cute. Like,
yeah.
How are you with her?
I'm getting better with kids. Like, right. I wasn't good, but she's helping me warm up. You yeah. know what I mean? And I feel like now I want to be in her life, play games with her.
Yeah,
like,
you
be present
need to.
Because I think I was always so awkward with kids.
Yeah.
They pass me the baby and I'm holding the baby like this.
No, I could see that. I could see that. But
I'm getting better. It yeah. takes time.
I think with children, you have to like, there's people who don't like kids, like yeah. who are awkward with kids. But then if you like, you have to understand, like, you want to be in their lives.
But that's what when I'm saying. Young. I yeah. can just give you, I don't have to be in your life. I can just
give
you the...
That'll here be it is. To be honest, I'd be fine with that because I could take care of my own. I don't need a sugar daddy. I don't need a guy who makes
great because I won't be one. That's an amazing setup right there.
I knew he was going to say something like that.
I don't have the sugar, nor will I be a daddy.
But no, I really just, I don't know. Like, obviously, I would want a man in my life, yeah, a yeah, male I mean, figure in my life. It would be, that would be the right thing to do. But like, if I can't find one, I would obviously have no choice but to do that because I was even thinking of adopting at one point.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I don't mind adoption at all. Like, honestly.
Good to know.
I know, that's a weird statement. I don't mind adoption. No, I'm saying because I think people are so married to the idea of like, it has to be my own blood type of thing. But no,
yeah,
but
sometimes
like,
it's not biologically possible too.
Yeah, right, that's so, true.
That's, it's not an easy task to just have.
And you know what else it is? I see my family, my brother. So my brother has two kids, right? My other brother doesn't have any kids. So I'm like, have a damn kid. Like, and I could see it. Like, I could see why they don't want to have a kid because the wife is so like, she's such a workaholic and she's like, I need to work and like stuff like that. And me, I'm looking at my family. I'm like, damn, I want to build my parents. Like, I want to build their legacy, you know, like I don't want them to like get older and older and have no grandchildren, you know? So I'm just like, it makes me really upset, but you know, I can't tell had my brothers how to live their life.
Do you
know?
Think like people care a little less about legacy now? Cause like you talk about our parents and they want grandkids. Like, is that something like you think we would care as like we become grandparents? Like, I mean, you know,
I think it's gonna be kids. Different as we get older, but I think,
Because I feel like maybe that's an older thing. Like you yeah. want your lineage to go for so long. I don't know if I really care about that now, you know?
No, I know, but that's cause you're not thinking of your family. You're not thinking yeah, you're about right. your, because look, my parents, I don't see them, right? But then I see my parents like wanting, they love their grandchildren, right? But it's like, no one's giving it to them except for my middle brother. And I want to give them so badly, but like, I can't just like pop a baby out one day, right?
Yeah.
But I mean, I could if
yeah,
I want
totally
to.
You totally could.
I totally could, but like, I would have to sacrifice a lot, right? But
like your nails maybe, yeah.
This
yeah, I could
listen.
Mom,
if I could
you're
have
stabbing
a,
me.
If I could have a child, I would literally give everything up. Like I could, if I could, but I can't obviously have one right now because I have so many shows right now. But it's like maybe next year. Hopefully, I find a man next year. Yeah.
Well, this is where it all starts at the Fun With Dumb podcast, guys. Leave your best pickup lines in the comments right now.
And we would shoot your shot. Yeah, yeah. Come to Korea and come see me because I can't go there. Like, I can't go to America. Like, I know I'm pretty sure that I can probably go to, like, Greece or, like, Italy or Europe or wherever, right? And probably meet a guy if I really try. But, like, I don't try, you know? Yeah. I get a lot of guys just like, you know, like, hey, like, you know, but it's just like, that's so like unmeaningful to me. Like,
All right.
So it's not practical, you know? Right. By the way, guys, this podcast, I don't watch any podcasts. Like, I actually watch Dumb With Fun. Like, I watch your clips. I like literally just scroll through your whole Dumb With Fun.
Yeah.
Are you sure you watch this pod? Are you sure you watch it?
My favorite host is Steffi.
Oh, yeah, like, she's great, yeah.
You're great. You're the best one. Like, you're the one who holds the whole fort, right?
Yeah.
Steffi is so f***ing adorable. Like,
so, marry, kill me, Steffi. No, okay. Yeah, I'm kidding. No, Steffi is great. She is like...
She's like the perfect... She's so witty and she's so awkward.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
And that's what makes it fun.
She's very cute, like, personality.
But then she's awkward.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
then
yeah.
She's just like so weird, but then she's so cute.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And she's like... She's so charming. Like, tell
she's
her
gonna,
I said hi.
She's going to love hearing that from you,
oh,
honestly.
Really?
Yeah.
Tell
yeah.
her I said hi. Like, I really, like, I love her. Like, I think without her, the show is just not fun.
I agree. She balances it
she
out.
She balances everything. Yeah. And then Rick, he has, like, a perfect balance of just, like...
He's the best. He throws me alley-oops and, you know, like, jokes.
I'm alley-oops. Not going to lie, though. I wish he would stop rapping on his mukbang. I don't know if
people
I'm the
love
first.
It. No, why you no, don't
no.
like it?
No, it's too deep. Like,
it's like inside rap.
Yeah, like his. He'd be like, it's like I just want to hear him eat yeah, and yeah. talk about the food.
You just sounded like chige boiling.
But I love his mukbang because you know he loves eating. That's great content, yeah. But it's like I just sometimes wish he would chill with the raps.
I got you. Well,
you know
he's gonna hear it now.
Yeah, right. Like love yeah. your content, love your mukbang. Yeah. That's what he does great at. He's good at like it's entertaining watching him eat. Right?
Well, I can't wait to see more of your content. That's not just album or music stuff, too. Yeah. I want to see you do a show like the show you were talking about earlier. That's like
be an amazing show.
Well, okay, content. No, that's not my goal, though, guys.
I know. No. I'm saying.
That's something I think would be very fun, right?
You are a multi-hyphenate. Like, I'm a multi-hyphenate. You know, yeah. I do music, this and that.
You're
like,
great
you
at
truly
that.
Are a natural multi-hyphenate.
Thank you.
No, real talk.
Thank you.
And I think that's why you've done so well in your career. You're so entertaining to watch. Listen let me say one more thing. I think you are, I would say, top five
goats.
No. Top five.
Am I a goat? I am a goat, no, though.
In Korea, you are top five greatest Korean performers of all
that's
time.
That's a goat.
All time. I would say for sure. I've gone to a concert, yeah. a festival, there's like 20 performers, and you're like top three every performance.
Who's number one?
I don't know, but I'm just saying. I'm just leaving space. No. I'm leaving space, all right? All right, well, Jessi, always a pleasure. Thank you for pulling up in your schedule.
No problem. I wasn't busy today.
Hasn't done an interview in like a whole year, and she decides to pull up to the pod.
Of course, for you.
Except for me specifically.
No, so. For you, because he's always down. He always helps me out too, so it's like... Now I can actually say after 7 years, right? How long have you been doing
the
your
last
podcast?
One was like 5 years ago, I think that one did. Yeah. Where I got shitted on in the comments. Yeah.
No, but now he's been doing it for so long, and that means that you're actually doing well.
Yeah, you know, we're on vacation and we're working, you know what I mean?
I mean, sorry.
Yeah, this is my vacation partner. I made him just the co-host.
You guys are going
here to
Bangkok after this?
Yeah, we're going to Thailand. Yeah.
I hope you guys have a good time. Make a lot of memories. Take a lot of pictures.
Yeah, definitely.
You know?
Yeah.
I realize I say this to everyone because pictures are the only things that last, man.
Yeah, zoom in, zoom out.
Mm-hmm.
On that note, tune in next week for another episode of Fun With Them. Thank you, Jessi.
No problem. Thank you. Thank you for having me. Bye.